A very warm welcome to our Deanery service for All Souls. And a very special warm thank you to Elaine, to John Roper for his beautiful music and singing, for Chris for his lovely photographs and music. And so we begin. This has been a year like no other year, with unprecedented and dangerous coronavirus pandemic overwhelming us all, adding to our sense of loss in so many different ways. Loss of freedom, loss of human contact, loss of the chance to visit those who are sick or in hospital or care homes, loss of life through COVID, loss of the chance to attend funerals, as well as the losses of friends and family themselves near to us. So this special service of reflection is a time to come together in our grief this year and to remember and celebrate those whom we love but are no longer with us. It will give time and space for some personal prayer and an opportunity to light a candle in memory of those people in your life that you wish to remember with love. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never comes to an end. We have a reading from the Book of Lamentations. My soul is bereft of peace. I have forgotten what happiness is. So I say, gone is my glory and all that I'd hoped for from the Lord. The thought of my affliction and my homelessness is wormwood and gall. My soul continually thinks of it and is bowed down within me. But this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore I will hope in him. The Lord is good to those who wait for him, to the soul that seeks him. It is good that one should wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord. So as we reflect on our loss and lament, we know that the journey of grieving is very hard. We'll all have some experience of this. And whether our losses are recent or from many, many years ago, each one of us needs our own time to grieve, don't we? May take a short time, may take years, and we may have experienced a whole jumble of difficult feelings. In our initial distress, we may have felt shock and the rawness of the loss. Tears and anger, numbness, rage, fear, loneliness, and such pain at times. Sometimes we feel guilty for the relief that death brings. Often we feel just exhausted. And others struggle with us, not knowing what to say to us. And we struggle with them. Often we don't want them to say anything at all, only just to be there or even perhaps go away. Malcolm Gait addresses God in this way. You know too well this trouble in our hearts. Your heart is troubled for us, feels it too. You share with us in time that shears and parts to draw us out of time and into you. So we find ourselves being drawn to God in our sadness. And however dark it may feel, we're never truly alone in that valley of the shadow of death. We are reminded of this as we sing that very favourite hymn with words taken from an ancient psalm. The Lord is my shepherd. Sometimes grief unsteadies us. We find we do not know whether we are coming or going, feeling our feet slipping, our thinking confused. We are bewildered, wondering whether perhaps, after all, we are going mad, wondering where it'll all end. We easily remember other old losses and griefs to add to our sadness, and can find ourselves sleepless and troubled by images and dreams. But some of those dreams may be sad, but some of those images and dreams are very, very precious. George Herbert summed up this muddled state of mind that we find ourselves in with deep insight in his poem, Bittersweet. I will complain, yet praise. I will bewail, approve. All my sweet, sour days, I will lament and love. God is love, travelling beside us through this dark valley, even alongside us in our confusion and bewilderment. Maybe we can find comfort and solace in yet another beautiful and ancient psalm. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills from whence cometh my help. My help cometh even from the Lord, who has made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved, and he that keepeth thee will not sleep. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord himself is thy keeper. The Lord is thy defence upon thy right hand, so that the sun shall not burn thee by day, neither the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. Yea, it is even he that shall keep thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth, for evermore. And so we pray, keep us, good Lord, under the shadow of your mercy and loving kindness. Be with us and support us, all of us who are anxious or fearful, sick or bereaved, and all who are brought low. Teach us that nothing can separate us from your love, O God, shown to us through the love of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. So we sing our next hymn, The Day Thou Gavest, Lord, Is Ended.
The day thou gavest, Lord, is ended.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. To you be glory and praise forever. Your steadfast love extends to the heavens, and your faithfulness never ceases. Illuminate our hearts with your wisdom, and strengthen our lives with your word. For you are the fountain of life, and in your light we see true light. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. And now I'm going to invite you to light your own candles to symbolize the light of Christ in our midst as our music begins. May the souls of the faithful departed rest in peace and rise in glory. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and may perpetual light shine upon them. Gradually, loss is transformed through love into hope. As we move onwards, there comes a gentle sense of awakening. A little light in the darkness, glimmers of hope emerge. Thanksgiving for those special memories that we begin to see beyond ourselves again. Begone beyond and outwards. The loving kindness of others makes our hearts glow with thankfulness. They help to cast that new light into our darkness. Like sunshine after rain, there are glimpses of heaven. Bright colours of autumn, colours of rich beauty to be seen. And how does that happen? I believe that God's grace is at work. As we start to open our eyes, enabling us to feel beloved and valued again, allowing our energy gradually to return, moving us onwards, and we're travelling again. Always carrying, of course, with us those very special memories that can be never taken from us. God's care and loving kindness has never left us all that way. But at last, we can feel its warmth again. And even if from time to time we feel another rush of grief, as often can happen to us unexpectedly, we have to remind ourselves that the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never comes to an end. And so let us pray a prayer of thanksgiving. Lord God, we give you thanks for all those whom we have loved but see no longer. We praise you as we remember their lives and cherish their memory. We bless you that in bearing your image, they have brought light into our lives. We thank you for every memory of love and joy, for every good deed done, for every sorrow shared. We also remember a time when it was hard, hard for them and hard for us. Heal any memories of hurt and failure, Lord, we pray, and bring us forgiveness and peace. For we have seen in their friendship reflections of your compassion, in their integrity, demonstrations of your goodness. In their loving kindness, glimpses of your eternal love. So we pray for comfort in our sadness, security in our doubt, and courage to live and direct our lives to doing good in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now I'm going to read the collect for All Souls Day. Merciful Father, hear our prayer and console us. As we renew our faith in your Son, whom you raised from the dead, strengthen our hope that all our departed brothers and sisters will share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever. Amen. Susan Ramsaran wrote a beautiful pilgrim's prayer. We give thanks for our life's pilgrimage, embraced by your eternal love, O God. We pray for those with whom we have shared adventure and companionship. Travel with us, Lord, through the uncertainties and expectations of our journey, from brokenness through penitence towards resurrection. May the journey bring vision, and our homecoming bring healing. May our renewed faith help us to bring hope to all those whom we meet, as you bless us, God of life, Christ of love, Spirit of grace. Amen. A beautiful piece from the letter to the Ephesians. And so we pray with the writer. I bow my knees before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth takes its name. I pray that according to the riches of his glory, he may grant that you may be strengthened in your inner being with power through his Spirit, and that Christ will dwell in your hearts through faith, as you are being rooted and grounded in love. I pray that you may have the power to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, so that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Amen. And so we say together the Lord's Prayer. Now we come to our final hymn. forth into the world in peace. Be of good courage. Hold fast to that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Honour everyone. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and with all those whom you love, tonight and always. Amen.